Human development and family studies means to me opportunity. With this degree, we can really work with any age group, any situation, any victimization like I've done with my internship, any steps of life, any stage.
Human development and family studies means helping families and their kids talk to each other, relate to each other, and teach them things that can make them more successful in life.
When I explain it to people, I explain it as sociology, psychology, social work. It's everything kind of lumped into one, and it's all about helping that person, helping your client. And that was what was crucial for me, because I knew I wanted to work with victims of crime, but I wanted to learn how to work with people first and then learn the criminal justice process second. And so that was what was a good fit for me, was to have the two in one.
It's such a broad major that you can really, you know, just get your feet wet into so many different directions, whether it be children and youth, mental disabilities, adults, elderly adults, you know. And I just feel that with my personality, I'm very nurturing, and I just wanted to be able to, you know, help those who really need it.
What I like most about the HDFS program is the things that we learned are easily applicable to the real world. Every skill, every paper that we think is annoying to have to write at the end of the semester, it's all for a reason. We actually use all of it in the real world.
My internship is at Bethany Christian Services. More specifically, I'm in our Safe Families for Children department. We do short-term hostings for families that are in crisis. So I set up the hostings. I find volunteer host families. I work with the placing parent, and I coordinate the hosting so that the parents can get back on their feet while the child is safe in someone's home.
So my internship was through the Pennsylvania Behavioral Health and Aging Coalition. They seek to advocate for older adults throughout the entire Commonwealth. And so we look for issues with substance abuse, mental health issues, even just simply financial status, such as, you know, trying to find Medicare coverage or health care, things like that.
Do you like the database research for the organization? I prep the lesson for what they're going to be doing. I do power hour weekly activity, which is what they're going to be doing throughout the whole week, Sunday, Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. And around 2 o'clock, I take my break. Then I go to Downey School, where I'm hands-on with the kids. So now I'm just interacting with the kids, helping them with their homework, making sure they're doing what they need, because the club is a positive club. So we have to make sure we keep those kids safe and making sure nothing actually happened to them.
I'm currently doing my internship at the Cumberland County District Attorney's Office, the Victim Service Division. I'm responsible for going to preliminary hearings, accompanying victims to court proceedings, and also giving them information about the court system and what to expect.
We've been very fortunate to have Penn State HDSF students here at Contact Helpline. As a matter of fact, we've actually hired some of our interns in the past because they've done such exceptional work for our organization. What we have found is that they're open to learning. They are very well prepared to come into an office environment for the first time. So they ask appropriate questions about office demeanor, what's going on in the office, and they're very excited to help out and learn.
Having an intern here has been a big help. I feel like we have been able to meet the needs of hospitals more, and also groups. And like I said, from my angle, as I develop new jobs for volunteers and board members, I've got a new thinking process, because I'm learning some new things that are out there in the field that weren't there 13 years ago when I started up this charity.
Having Penn State students intern here, the experience has been just a great collaborative effort. I find that the students are well prepared when they come in. My experience has been they are very enthusiastic, willing to learn, and come in with a sense of confidence.
Any HDFS student that we've had has come very prepared, very eager to learn. They're very actively involved in their time here. They work over the hours that they need to because they enjoy their time here. They're ready to do anything. They're very creative. They've done areas of research with some other professors at Penn State Harrisburg, which has been beneficial to our program. So it's been an overall great experience and given us the opportunity to actually hire two interns full-time here.
I started working my full-time job in February. I work for Safe Families for Children. I'm an outreach coordinator. So I plan to continue doing that for the next few years and see what happens after that. I think eventually I'd like to get a master's in counseling or social work though.
My plans after graduation are to hopefully get a job in the human services field. I think I have a position open at Compass Mark, which is where I plan to apply, and I'll be working with young adults and youth on how to stay out of drugs and alcohol or for rehabilitation.
Through shadowing with my internship at other agencies, I actually received a job offer from Domestic Violence Services of Cumberland and Perry Counties. So I'll be starting there before graduation.
I've actually accepted a full-time position at Country Meadows Retirement Communities. thank you. I'm in their home care division. Right now I'm their employment specialist and sort of their office manager at the same time. So it's a little bit more administrative, but there's so much room for growth and I'm getting a lot of experience working with our staff and understanding more of the home care one-on-one perspective.
It means so much. It means, again, a sense of unity that I had with my education. It meant friends, it meant family, it meant Penn State, it meant everything, you know, and I see it every single day in my job. It means helping people. It means doing what you can for a person that can't do it for themselves. It means referring someone and constantly following up on them to make sure that they're okay. It means making sure you do what you can to help educate a victim to not go back to their domestic violence abuser, to not go back to the ex-boyfriend who sexually assaulted them. It means helping around the clock and actually loving what you're doing. But overall, I would say the HDFS program at Penn State means the world to me, and it means so much to so many other people. And we're just now in the process of educating people on our program. And I think that the more we do that, the more victims and the more people will be able to help on the outside.